Hello.
Hello.
How you all doing today?
Well, we're good. I don't know about her.
Okay, so this is Camilla?
Yes.
Hey, beautiful.
Hi, baby. Oh my goodness, you're such a sweetheart.
Yeah.
You shake? Hey, baby.
Say hi, Dr. Blue.
She got such a cute bulldog face, too. It's like she's just smiling.
She doesn't like being far from us. If we're in the kitchen, she's in the kitchen. If we're in the living room, she's in the living room.
Camilla is, she 3 years old?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So what's going on with her?
She went through, like, I guess through her heat cycle. This is our first time having a female, so.
Okay.
Afterwards, her nipples, one of them was swollen.
Okay.
And then eventually it started to protrude. And I thought, like, it was kind of normal.
Like a part of her heat cycle or something.
Exactly. You know, I was like reading up, you know, and that's what I thought that it was. And then
right.
It seemed to go away for a little bit, but then it came back.
Ooh, it actually looks like one of her nipples was enlarged and then it ruptured. It's pretty radical, this thing's, I mean, it's like the size of a pickle.
Masses can be very unpredictable. The mass on Camilla's mammary gland could have developed easily within a couple of weeks.
Has she been acting painful or anything?
No,
she looks happy.
No, no. She doesn't act like it's bothering her at all. I mean, it just, as you see.
Right.
Anytime that there is mammary gland that looks like this, you have to be concerned with mammary gland cancer.
So it is a tumor. I don't know if it's benign or if it's cancerous.
In mammals, we have mammary glands. In the case of Camilla, she actually has developed a mass on her mammary gland.
That truly needs to be removed. Since we're going to be removing that, we might as well just take the rest of that chain with us.
Because it's connected to a chain, which is several different teats or nipples that come on a dog, then I want to remove all of those that could be affected by this tumor.
I highly recommend Spanner.
Yeah, do you think that that's what caused this?
I'm not gonna say that's the sole cause, but there is scientific evidence that suggests that the more heat cycles that they have, the more of an increased chance you have for development of mammary cancer.
Okay, how soon can something like that be done?
We can get her checked in and get it done as soon as possible.
Okay. Yeah, we definitely want to move forward in very much love. We need her taken care of.
Oh, you can tell. All right, little baby.
I'm here today with a 3-year-old female intact bulldog. There's a stat that each time a dog has a heat cycle, it actually increases the chances of mammary cancer. Our goal today is to remove a very large mass that has developed on one of her nipples. In addition to that, we'd like to get her spayed. That way, we can rid her of any chance of getting any more heat cycles.
What I'm gonna do first is, because I have to make an incision around the mammary chain anyway,
yeah.
I'm gonna just go ahead and start with the spay. Then I'll remove the affected mammary gland. Whoa. What is this? Oh my God. What the hell?
Camilla's down on the surgical table. Going for the spay should be routine. I noticed that the uterus was kind of thickened and I couldn't get it out. So I had to extend my incision. When I did that, I noticed some weird things.
What you got, Doc? Is she pregnant or is that a pile?
I think she got uterine cancer. It's a huge mass in here. Look at this.
Oh.
We found that the uterus has deformed quite a bit with several masses within the uterus. We're potentially dealing with either two separate cancers or one cancer that has spread to the other organs. We're gonna continue with the surgery as planned. I'm gonna remove this first ovary. We were able to get the mass out along with the uterus and then also do an exploratory in a fair amount of time. All right, so now I'm going for the large mammary mass. A really large vessel here. I'm trying my best not to injure. When there's a tumor and or cancer, you have to realize it's asking for more blood supply so it can grow.
You was able to get it all out?
Yeah, I had to find a little window for it, but I got it.
Well, you're a bad son of a gun, I tell you.
Last stitch in here. I'm gonna have you recover her. Let's get her warmed up. I'm gonna go talk to the parents.
This is Angela.
Hey, Angela, how you doing? This is Dr. Blue over here at Cypher Adult Hospital. How you feeling today?
My stomach is a little queasy because I'm nervous about what you're going to tell me.
Well, we went in to do the spay. The uterus and the ovaries were completely abnormal. I mean, it was huge. This thing was the size of a baseball. I'm concerned that we're dealing with some type of adenocarcinoma. It's a form of cancer. I don't know if we're dealing with uterine cancer, ovarian cancer, and mammary cancer as three separate entities.
Oh, gosh.
We've taken samples, so we're gonna find out what is the actual outcome of these masses. Okay?
Okay.
The important part is that she's doing well, we keep her feeling well, and we start the healing process. Camilla's a very nice, smiley, tail wagging, you know, loving dog. We're gonna hope that she continues to do that regardless of the outcome. Okay?
Okay.
Okay? Ooh. I know it's been a long few days for Camila's family, but she is healing great. And if her tail is any indication, she can't wait to go home.
Let's go see mommy. This way.
Oh my goodness, look at her. She looks so good.
She never skipped a beat.
No?
No, like pre-surgical, post-surgical, discharge, she is just wagging along, having a good time.
My stomach was in a knot.
Right.
Definitely.
You know, she had quite an extensive procedure that we had to end up doing. She came to us with that big, large mass on her mammary gland that ruptured, and I had recommended spaying her while she was under, of course, with the intention of going in routinely removing it.
Yeah.
And lo and behold, this is what we found.
Oh, my God.
It was an extremely, extremely large ovary. This thing is softball size.
Like, how come she wasn't swollen or anything? Like,
well,
like her stomach wasn't protruding or that area didn't seem swollen. She didn't seem painful, like me touch.
You'd be so surprised how well these animals do because either they're sometimes not in pain,
mm-hmm.
it's not enough pain to really cause a problem,
mm-hmm.
or you're dealing with an issue where they're just so well behaved, you can't really decide or discern that there's pain there.
Okay.
Either way, we were able to remedy the issue by doing a complete ovarian hysterectomy. So we took out her ovaries and her uterus. We have all of those samples to the laboratory, and she deserves to have a clean bill of health.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Hi. I'm a good one.
Come on, Camila. Let's go. Let's go, Mama. You're going home. Come on.
How you doing, kiddo?
One of our protocols here at Cypher Animal Hospital is after a surgery for our clients to come back so we can see them for their rechecks. Camilla's no different. I would like to go over the results that I got back from the histopath on that mass so we can have her completely diagnosed and treated.
So eating and drinking normal, pooping, peeing normal.
Yes.
Vomiting, coughing, sneezing, diarrhea.
Nothing. I mean, she seems to be doing well.
Good. I'm so glad to hear that.
Yeah.
So, let's get down to the nitty-gritty. I got the reports back, and there are several different things going on. So, let's start with what we came in for originally. So, the actual mammary gland, that is what they're calling a mammary gland carcinoma. But that tells us that it is something that is malignant. With that being said, we did get complete and full margins, meaning that we did remove it in totality.
So, okay.
Even things that are cancerous are not always a death sentence. The good thing is you were very proactive in getting it removed.
Okay.
Okay? the uterus. It's what we call a leiomyoma, and that is not cancerous. The actual ovary itself, that large right ovary.
Mm-hmm.
They're calling that a granular cell tumor. That tumor can sometimes act as a metastatic type of cancer. I think 2 out of 12 dogs with these type of cells actually spread to other parts of the body or metastasize.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Most of the time, the removal of it is, you know, curative. Having said all of that, if we wanted to further diagnose and or treat that, I would need to refer you to an oncologist.
Okay.
They'll be able to tell you the likelihood of return or metastasis or treatment options.
Okay.
I have dogs that have had different type of cancers that lead a normal life. And that's with or without actual chemo or radiation therapy.
Okay. I am very concerned, and I know my household is gonna be probably in tears trying to figure, process it all, but it's just, it's kind of hard because we see her so happy. We see her moving around. It just, you can't imagine that there would be anything else wrong with her.
Right. Well, we're definitely always gonna hope and pray for the best. And we're gonna use our understanding of what we do know so we can make the proper decisions. Let's take her home and let her live happy and keep going. And I'll get that report over to you. And if you'd like to get to the oncologist, I'd like to send you over there. Sending Camilla to the oncologist will help her. The oncologist can actually tell Camilla's owner what treatment plan she would recommend for this type of cancer, the cost of it, and the duration. All right, we'll see you later.
Bye, friend. Oh, bye, little buddy. Bye, baby.
You're gonna be okay. Yes, you are.